Good morning. Thanks for joining us this morning for another Emerging Artist Series concert. I have to say, I'm a pianist, but it has to be a good day when we have the fortune of hearing string quartets all day. So we have two string quartets on today's concert, and tonight the Brentano Quartet will perform two more string quartets. I want to thank the Brentano Quartet for being here the past 2 weeks and working with the fellows and also giving great concerts. Sadly, we have to bid them goodbye, and next week the Miro Quartet will join us, and I hope you can hear them. The week next week starts actually on Wednesday night with a masterclass by the flutist Tara Helen O'Connor. So thanks for being here and enjoy the concert.
Good morning, and thanks for joining us today. So we'll be playing the Schumann String Quartet No. 3 in A major. Of Schumann string quartets, this is the most traditional, you know, the most kind of grounded, what you will hear if you listen to other composers, which Schumann was thoroughly studying at the time. But of course, it has its own Schumann little magic. You'll hear the kind of Clara motif, and that's what actually opens the entire piece. You'll hear the first violinist, Laura, she'll play it in the very beginning, and it's actually what ends the first movement in the cello. So it kind of wraps everything up in a nice bow, and then we're off to the second movement. And here is, I think, the first most notable example of Schumann's upbeats. You'll hear it, it's a set of variations, and inside the variations is kind of the core theme, so it's almost kind of tucked away somewhere that you have to find. And Schumann uses these upbeats, this emphasis, to create kind of a falling forward feeling, and it's kind of what begins the second movement and gets us off on our way. And another case of him using these upbeats is actually in the fourth and final movement, my personal favorite, but he uses it in a different way. Whereas the second movement, he kind of creates this almost, at least as a player, I almost feel a little anxious, almost if I'm going to catch myself in time. But the fourth movement is all of us playing in unison, and we're very much going forward. It's like this this ball of energy that's constantly moving. And the fourth movement is such a fun movement. It's part of why I wanted personally to learn the piece, and so I'm really, really grateful to finally be able to have done that with these three especially. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Good morning, everyone, and thank you for being here. My name is Emily, and I'm the violist of this group. And my colleagues and I are so excited to be performing Bartók's fourth string quartet for you today. This dramatic and incredibly precisely composed work takes us on an out and back journey through all five movements. Five movements that are actually symmetrical in both character and length. From the radical and harmonically dense outer movements, the short, fun, second and fourth movements, to the desolation and profound quality of the third and middle movement, the centerpiece of the work and an example of Bartók's famous night music. Arguably the most chromatic of his six string quartets, the fourth quartet comes across as extremely complicated. Chords are often arranged in seemingly clashing clusters, not always easy on the ears, and melodies are often layered on top of one another, sometimes only allowing brief, recognizable motifs to peek out as they get passed around the quartet. But do not despair, because while the movements are extremely intricate, they're also amusing and enjoyable in their own ways. With key melodies in Bartók's music coming from Hungarian folk songs, there's always something to latch onto as a listener. I wanted to leave you with a couple of words that we all think resonate for each movement. For the first, academic, yet rustic and folky. Second movement is windy and murmuring. Third is the beauty and darkness of nature at night. Fourth is dance-like and humorous. And fifth is a raw, dare I say, headbanger. So without further ado, this is Bartók's fourth string quartet. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.